The majority of Filipinos want the Marcos Jr. administration to work with the U.S. to defend the West Philippine Sea. The latest Pulse Asia survey shows 84% of respondents want America to help the Philippines defend its sovereignty in the disputed waters. Over half of the respondents want the Philippines to work with Japan, while over a quarter favor increased cooperation with Australia. Half of the respondents believe the Marcos Jr. administration should boost the country's military capability. They especially want a stronger Navy and Coast Guard to effectively address security issues in the West Philippine Sea.
The Philippines clinches $22 billion in investment pledges from China during the state visit of President Marcos Jr. Marcos described his engagement with Chinese leaders as cordial and fruitful.
These are pledges, but they are pledges that are backed up already by concrete actions in the Philippines. Nagbukas na sila ng mga opisina, nagkumukuha na sila ng mga permit. Yung mga iba na nakakuha na ng permit, inumpisahan na nila yung mga construction.
Meanwhile, Marcos clarified that the decision on when Filipino fisher folks can return to their traditional fishing grounds occupied by Chinese vessels in the West Philippine Sea is not a matter that would be unilaterally decided by China. That's despite Chinese President Xi Jinping's earlier vow that he would look for a compromise for Filipinos to regain fishing grounds in the disputed waters.
I see it as a lack of communication or rapid communication. So sabi mo, gumawa tayo ng paraan para kung may problema from either side, sabihin nyo, magsasabi kami sa inyo kagad, sabihin nyo rin kami kagad. Kung magpapalipad kayo ng rocket, sabihin nyo sa amin, kung may bumagsak sa Pilipinas, i-recover namin, bibigay naman namin sa inyo. Hindi naman wala kaming interest na itago yan. If the commanders of the Philippine Coast Guard and the Navy and the commanders of the Chinese Coast Guard and their Navy magkakilala yan, eh madali silang mag-usap bago may mangyari pa.
Marcos adds, the Philippines and China have agreed to forge closer bilateral ties and focus on common interests to soothe tensions brought about by maritime disputes. He also says he has invited Xi to visit Manila. A procedural mistake. That's how President Marcos Jr. described the sugar importation mess that hounded the start of his administration last year. Marcos has cleared four former agriculture officials of any wrongdoing over an unauthorized sugar order that would have allowed the importation of 300,000 metric tons of sugar. Those absolved are former Agriculture Undersecretary Leocadio Sebastian, Sugar Regulatory Administrator Hermenegildo Serafica, and board members Roland Beltran and Aurelio Valderrama Jr.
We are mindful of the decision. It was basically a mistake, a procedural mistake that happened. So we'll proceed on that basis. Whatever plans we have for you, Sec. Sebastian, I think he should hear them first, not over the news. So pag-uusapan namin.
Sebastian says the president's decision can help him move forward from what he calls a traumatic experience. For Beltran, this proves he dutifully carried out his mandate to the people. Valderrama, meanwhile, says it's now time to set issues aside to confront challenges of the sugar industry. Serafica has yet to issue a statement.
The chairman of the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee panel says the dismissal does not affect their committee report recommending charges against the agriculture officials. Senator Francis Tolentino points out the Senate is independent from the executive, but Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel lauds the decision, which he says is a vindication of the poor officials. The Senate Minority Bloc previously rejected the majority's report, saying that those officials who signed the sugar order acted in good faith. The Agriculture Department says it respects the President's decision, but it has yet to decide on how to welcome Undersecretary Sebastian back to the agency.
Yan po ang pinag-usapan namin doon sa Department of Agriculture, kung ano pong position or kung anong sitwasyon kung sakaling babalik po, na which is sabi nga ni Yusek Leo na babalik siya. Maganda po siguro na mag-audience si Yusek Sebastian doon sa Office of the President.